Next type of asexual reproduction, that is of budding. Budding. In budding, a small outgrowth originated in the parental plant, then it will develop, grow, and it is from parental plant to form the new plants or new organism, that is of budding. Budding occurs in both unicellular and multicellular. Budding that is occurring both type of organism, that is unicellular and multicellular. But the budding is small outgrowth origin on parental cells that grow and it is from parent to form new plants or new organism. That is of budding. If we see in the unicellular, that is of yeast. In yeast, it is the single cell fungi. This is the unicellular yeast, this nucleus. At the time of budding, a small outgrowth is originated with the apical parts of the parental cells, and its nucleus will be elongated and grow gradually. Nucleus constricted from the center and detached into two portions. Nucleus detached into two portions, and the parental cells completely detached and form the new or daughter organism or new organism, that is the budding. Initially nucleus elongated, initially that bud like structure is there, small outgrowth is there, then nucleus elongated, one portion of nucleus moved toward the bud, another portion remained in the parental cells, then it will be detached from the parental cells to form the new organism. It is the budding in yeast. Budding is also present in the multicellular organism. Multicellular, the example is of Hydra. Hydra is the multicellular organism in which this is the parental Hydra. You can say Hydra. Hydra has 5 tentacles at the apical portion that help in the capturing of food material or protect from enemies. Initially, or in more favorable conditions, at the base portion of Hydra, a small outgrowth is formed. Then, on this small outgrowth, small tentacles will be formed. It's like new daughter Hydra, and then daughter Hydra will be detached from the parental cells to form new Hydra. Daughter Hydra detached from the parental cell to form new Hydra. This is the process of budding. This is a bud, and this is the new Hydra. I want to share one diagram of budding process with you.
that is this is the this diagram show budding in Hydra, sorry, Hydra. These are the tentacles and this is the main body of the Hydra. At the time of budding, this small buddies appear at the base of the Hydra and that will be grow to form new tentacles and like a daughter Hydra. Then after it will be separate from the parent and lie freely in the water. This is the budding, which is in the multicellular organism, budding in Hydra. Now, if we discuss another type of asexual reproduction, that is of spore formation. Another type of asexual reproduction, that is of spore formation. Spore formation. Normally, it is occurring in fungi. If you see in the fungi filament grow horizontally on the dead organic matter. They are grow horizontally in the dead organic matter. And it can also reproduce with the fungal filament or fungal hyphae. Sometimes it also reproduces with the help of spore formation. At the time of reproduction, some vertical branches from this fungal hyphae is originated, and the tip will be enlarged. The tip of the vertical branches will be enlarged and nucleus is collected here in this swollen portion of the or enlarged portion of these branches. Then nucleus divided with the three nuclear division that form many nuclear group 4, 4 to 8 with the mitosis 2 to 4, 1 to 2, 2 to 4, 4 to 8, 8 to 16, 16 to 32, and after that, around each and every nuclei, some cytoplasm is get collected and form cell membrane. हर nucleus की चारों तरफ थोड़ा-थोड़ा cytoplasm collect हो जाता है और cell membrane बन जाती है. This is the fungal hypha or fungal filament. This is the stalk of this portion. We can say this is known as sporangium. And inside that, spore is there. So spore containing structure, bulb-like structure, which is known as sporangium. And the stalk of sporangium is known as sporangiophore. These are the sporangium in which many spores is there. Whenever these sporangium mature, they will burst and release the spores. These spores transfer from one place to another place through the various agency. They may be air, water, or through any other modes. They can transfer one place to another place. Whenever they reach on the suitable place, means that dead organic matter in suitable condition, these spores produce new germinate. These spores germination is the percentage of spore or spore and germination spore germination there, and after the germination they produce that
fungal filaments or fungal hypha. Then again spore formation will be there. So this is the spore formation which is occurring in fungi. Example, rhizopus, mucor, penicillium and other fungi. Maximumly, whenever the fungi reproduce through the asexual reproduction, they reproduce with the help of spore formation. We discussed different mode of asexual reproduction.
Before that, I want to share one more diagram of spore formation with you. This is the diagram of spore formation. Just I want to show, this one is of budding. This is the diagram of spore formation. Yes, this one is the horizontal filaments or horizontal hypha. Okay, these root like structure, but not roots, because in fungi roots is not there. These are the vertical branches. These are the vertical branches. We can say that is sporangiophore, and at the tip of sporangiophore, these bulb-like structure is formed, which is known as sporangium. Inside the sporangium, spores is there. Spores is there, and when sporangium will mature, that will be brushed out, and the spores disperse through the various agency, air, water, or any other types of agency. So this is the diagram of spore formation. Now, we discuss
the different types of asexual reproduction, that is of fission. These are two types, binary fission and multiple fission. Second one is of fragmentation. Another one is of regeneration. Another one is of budding, and these different types of asexual reproduction we discussed. Now, one more type of sexual reproduction is there, that is of vegetative propagation. Vegetative propagation. These different types, that is fission, fragmentation, regeneration, budding, spore formation, these various types of reproduction are in the lower organism. But the vegetative reproduction, it is present in the angiosperm and higher plants. Vegetative means it reproduces with the help of vegetative parts. If transitive part is there, one is the reproductive parts, another range of vegetative parts, reproductive parts, reproductive parts, angiosperm reproduction, that for sexual reproduction. But for vegetative reproduction, that is a type of asexual reproduction, that is a root germ or leaves. We'll discuss in the next period, that is of vegetative reproduction.